One of the most difficult things you'll find when creating custom shaders is math. A description of each node in Shader Graph is in the Unity official documentation, but it is not easy for beginners to fully understand all of this. In addition, some YouTubers simply used color changes as an example when explaining the math nodes of Shader Graph, making it difficult to accurately understand and apply these math nodes. The purpose of a shader is to define the color of each pixel displayed on the screen. Therefore, I agree that shader creation should also focus on the color of the result. However, much of the internal code of shaders operates mathematically, so understanding colors as numbers will help you write shaders. In this lesson, let's learn about the basic math functions most used in Shader Graph. The Shader Graph version used in this video is 14. Before explaining, I prepared a GLSL grapher to help you understand mathematical functions. The GLSL grapher has the advantage of being able to use most shader functions. Since a two-dimensional graph is used, the vertical line corresponds to the result y, and the horizontal line corresponds to the transformation value x. This graph is basically used as a scale of lightness and darkness. The darkest value is 0, and the lightest value is 1. You can see that all calculations are done between 0 and 1. Now, let's look at the basic math functions of Shader Graph along with the graph. This function, as its name suggests, adds variables. If you look at the graph, the position of the line changes. This means there is a change in the overall brightness of the color. Adding values increases the overall brightness. Conversely, adding a negative value makes it darker. The subtract function is similar to add, but the input variable is always negative, so it gets darker as the value increases. Therefore, it is used to lower the brightness of a specific area, or for complex calculations. The multiply function changes the slope of the line on the graph. This is because 0 multiplied by any number becomes 0. Therefore, the position of the rotating axis remains the same, so only the remaining range changes while maintaining a very low value. The divide function is literally the opposite of multiply. As the input variable value increases, the result value decreases. However, if you substitute a value lower than 1, the result increases and you can see that it is the same as multiply. The thing to be careful about is to ensure that the input value does not become 0. In mathematics, not all numbers can be divided by 0. If you divide a constant by 0, the shader will generate an error and display purple. Also, dividing 0 and 0 creates an indeterminate form, which also causes an error in the shader. This can be handled through range functions, which will be explained in the next video. The power function is to keep multiplying the same value. For example, 2 to the 4th power is the same as multiplying 2 4 times, resulting in 16. When you multiply negative numbers by an even number, the result is positive. However, when you multiply a negative number with a positive number, the result is always negative. If you look at it this way, you can see that the value of 0 and 1 does not change even if you square it. Since the change only occurs between 0 and 1, the graph becomes a curve rather than a straight line. If you look at the shader's results, you can see that the mid-brightness area is expanded or narrowed. While power means multiplying the same value every time, square root is the opposite of power as it finds the root of a specific value. For example, the square of 3 is 9, and the square root of 9 is 3. If it's not easy to understand, let's find out using a calculator. For example, the square root of 25 is 5. Multiply this value twice to get 25. The square root of 42 is approximately 6.4807. Multiplying this square root twice gives 41.999, which is close to 42. As previously explained about power, multiplying the same negative numbers together results in a positive number, so the exact square root of 9 is plus or minus 3. If you look at this logic, there is something to be careful about. The variable to calculate the square root must be a positive number. If a negative value is input, the shader outputs purple, which is an error value. If you look at the GLSL grapher, you can see that the curve changes sharply as it approaches 0, and becomes gentler as it approaches 1. This means that the change value is small beyond a certain area. Multiplying numbers lower than 1 is easy to understand. If you look at the shader, you can see that the input value is at maximum brightness. You can also see that the change is small at maximum brightness.